Welcome to Organization Access, the second video in the Who Sees What series. These videos provide admins the basics on visibility and data access in Salesforce. One of the first things you'll need to do is give your users access to your Salesforce organization. By default, Salesforce does not restrict the hours when a user can log in or the locations from where they can log in. For increased security, you can set up a range of trusted IP addresses at the company level. People logging in from outside this range are sent an activation code. They can log in once they've entered this code. You can also set up IP ranges at the profile level. If you do, users logging in from outside the range aren't sent an activation code. They're denied access. You can also specify hours that users can access the org. Users who try to log in outside these hours will be denied access. Keep in mind, if they are in the middle of a session, that session will end. Let's take a look at AW Computing's org, where we'll set the trusted IP range and login hours. We're going to set up our call center reps so they can log into Salesforce during standard business hours and from a restricted IP range. Then, we'll set up our sales reps so they can log into Salesforce anytime from any IP address. First, let's check the company IP range. We find this in the setup pages under Settings, Security, Network Access. We've already set up the trusted IP range addresses at AW Computing. Anyone who logs in from outside this range will be sent an activation code. They can use this code to log in from their current location. This works unless we further restrict IP ranges at the profile level. This is what we'll do for our call center reps. Call center reps should only be accessing Salesforce during standard business hours and only while they are in the office. We go to Users, Profiles, and select Call Center Rep. Click the Login IP Ranges link and click Add IP Ranges. We add the same IP range that was used for the company. By specifying the IP range here at the profile level, anyone with this profile trying to log in from outside this range won't be sent an activation code to log in. They'll be denied access. Now, let's set up the login hours for our call center reps. Our call center reps can be in the system from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday and the same hours for the rest of the week. Here's a tip. If you set the hours as 12 a.m. to 12 a.m., it locks anyone with that profile out for the whole day. So we set Saturday and Sunday to 12 a.m. to 12 a.m. and click Save. Now, we'll set up our sales reps. They need access to their data around the clock, from in the office or on the road. So we go back to Profiles and select the Sales Rep profile. Login IP ranges are located at the bottom of their profile page. We won't set an IP range at the profile level. This means that if a sales rep logs in from an address outside the range we set for the company, they'll be sent an activation code, and they'll use that to log in. Now, let's look at their login hours. We also leave the login hours unchanged. This grants sales rep users access to the system around the clock. We're done. We've just granted our sales reps and call center folks access to the org. To learn more about visibility and access, check out all the videos in this series. You can also search for these topics in Salesforce Help, or come join us on the trail at trailhead.salesforce.com. Up next, we'll dive into controlling object access with profiles and permission sets. Thanks for watching.